I just stepped on a plane, my bag's on the shelf. I find my seat in the middle and plan to keep to myself. The pilot comes on, says there's been a delay, and I sigh, buckle up and prepare for the wait. There's a middle-aged woman on my right by the window. No ring on her finger, maybe divorced or a widow. She's drafting an email, and from where I am seated, I can side-eye that shit, so of course I'm gonna read it. It said, "Dear McCracken, this is already great. Dude's got a pen pal and a killer last name." She opens with an inside joke, and she's hoping to set a casual tone, her words carefully chosen. She was sure that her week spent in Houston would drag, but then a face from her past quickly changed all of that. The trip was for business, she's used to the travel, but this time she's not ready to head back to Seattle. Dear McCracken, I'd rather be off this plane. I can't admit the half of it that I want to say. Do I pretend? Do I push you away? I'm jet lagging, McCracken, and I'll give you your space. I can tell by the abuse of the backspace key, there's a heart balanced on how her words are perceived. She's retyped that fourth paragraph four times, swinging the tone back and forth until she's so satisfied that he knows that even though their paths have diverged, there's an air of regret, but not enough to reverse. And I am stunned, there I sit, completely convinced that once you grow old, you stop dealing with this. The uncertain, the hurting, the feeling like dirt when things don't work out by the fall of the curtain. She hits send, powers off, and we're ready to go.